Hello Aquarius, how are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. If you're new, welcome. I'm so glad to have you, and I want to thank everyone who has been so delightful in helping me grow the channel with their likes, subscribes, comments, shares. It's the only way a YouTube channel grows, so we always ask if you like a creator, if it resonates with you, that you help them out. Okay, the energy at the bottom of the deck, Aquarius, is Four of Swords. Four of Swords energy is Libra energy. It looks like you're tuckered out from the holidays. We see this person in a very peaceful state of repose, getting in touch with your emotions, you know, not trying to be involved too much in anything that's taxing or energetically draining to you. Smart energy. So let's see what your person is thinking about you at this time. Well, they think you could be the one. The Two of Cups. The Two of Cups energy is Cancerian energy. It is a bride and groom in the traditional Rider-Waite deck, taking their vows, offering a cup of love to one another, making a commitment to see each other exclusively. So it really speaks to the fact that your person sees you as the one. They see you as sweet, as kind, as delightful. They see you, of course, with this Libra energy as being very, very smart, very, very much a person that takes things to heart. The Two of Swords is crossing the energy of their feelings for you, and it shows that they're not really telling you how they feel. The Two of Swords is sort of like, well, I'm not ready to talk yet. We'll talk about that when the time is right. Two of Swords energy is also, you know, they're trying not to look at something, either within themselves or within the situation, but they're watching very carefully. This is really kind of a tricky card, because the truth is that this person sees everything they want to see, but they don't talk about it. So they're observing you very closely. They're observing you sort of covertly, and they're trying to see how you're going to interact with them. What brings them to the reading is they want to absolutely charge into the relationship. They want things their way. We see an emperor here, female emperor, pulling strings, using sort of a seductive energy to get what they want with you. In the recent past, the energy has been all about eat, drink, be merry, laugh, let's go out, let's have fun, let's travel, let's make love, do a little dance, you know. It's all about sort of sitting at the table of life and feasting. The energy at this time in terms of what they want to achieve with you is a world card. They want to go to the next level. They want success with you. They think the world of you. They love the laughter. They love the joy. They love the energy that the two of you have together. They do hold back a little bit, though, when I see this energy. In the near future, what can you expect? This person is manifesting you. That is the energy. This is Saturn energy, so it means that they take the relationship very seriously. They want a commitment. When we look at the Magician card, they find you magical. The chemistry is magical. Physically, the chemistry is magical. Emotionally, they feel delighted and happy. They always feel like a day with you is a day of magic. Is, you know, it's like being at the party of life. They see life as being very special with you. They are manifesting you. They have all the tools to do it. They feel as though you have all the tools to be everything that they want in a relationship also. It is a combination of Virgo and Gemini energy. Good communication will be coming in the future. They're going to open up with you. They're going to talk in a much more direct way with you. Gemini is very direct, very blunt sometimes. But also, this person knows how to take care of a relationship and nurture it day to day. Virgo, the Virgin, you know, they're very pure in terms of what they want. They are well-intentioned with you. They understand that day-to-day life, it requires texting you daily. It requires, you know, and they want to do it anyway. So this person finds a day-to-day life with you very joyful. In terms of what's coming up for you, they are showing off. They're trying to woo you with their daring. So I don't know if you're going to go horseback riding. I don't know if you're going on a vacation, but this person has an adventurous spirit. They want to do activities with you that could be a little bit more physical, could be involved in athletics. They might want to run, jog, go hiking, go to exotic destinations. But we see a person who likes the finer things in life and they are willing to leap through a hoop to get them. This is also the energy, though, of thrill seeking. It's also the energy of not being committed. It can be in and out. It can be about the passion. But I temper that because I do see that in their heart space, they're not telling you anything. They haven't opened up these emotions, you know, but we see that they have this desire to manifest. So what we see is they're not talking now, but they soon will. How they view the situation with you. The Wheel of Fortune, when the time is right, they see a Sagittarius energy. This is Sagittarius energy. Sagittarius energy is oftentimes long distance travel. It can be different cultures. You could meet it in a arena of higher education, university. When you really think you're passing through, you could meet while you're traveling. But it speaks to the fact that they want to have adventure in life, and they're hoping you want the same. The Wheel of Fortune is when the timing is right, and they see that as being in the near future, that they will open up their feelings and share with you what their true intentions are. Right now, they're sort of keeping those to themselves. We see their biggest fear is a Tower card, that they are not building a strong enough foundation with you. They don't want things to fall apart. That's why they will step into sharing with you how they feel when they think the time is right. And the Outcome card is the Three of Cups. This could be somebody that you consider a dear friend. They consider friendship to be a huge part of an important relationship. They are looking for a partner, a friend, a lover, somebody with whom to live larger than life with, to share adventures with. And they see you as that person who is that person. They see that about you. So let's look and see what Spirit is telling us about the situation at this time, Aquarius. What is Spirit going to let us know about this connection that you have with this person? Angel of Love. Aw, they see you as an angel. Aquarius, you usually have a very high moral standard. Okay, but they see you in very soft, loving terms. They think you're sweet, you're kind, you're loving. The Healer of the Ages. Aquarius, interesting energy. It looks as though you might know this person or you might have met this person through some sort of spiritual journey, healing journey. You may be actually healing right now. And that could be physically, emotionally. You could be just exhausted. They're trying to give you your space. Libra energy, very much trying to find your balance again. It looks like you could be tuckered out again from career, but they want a best friend and lover. They want a marriage partner. The Sun card, look at that, the happiest card in the deck. They find you as being the person with whom they enjoy the most amount of just pure, unadulterated. Life is good every day when they get up and talk to you. I'm going to clarify the energy of the Four of Swords. The Sun card, we just see a person here who's waiting for the right time to manifest this relationship. Let's look and see the Four of Swords, though. Let's get some clarification here about this energy for you, Aquarius. Why are you in this Libra energy trying to balance things out? You look exhausted. What is going on here with our Aquarius friends? From your person's viewpoint, let's see what we have here. The Daughter of Swords. Okay, Page of Swords energy. They feel as though your job or whatever you're doing is sort of exhausting mentally for you. Page of Swords is that you're asked to do a lot of research, a lot of almost maybe even chores and obligations that you have at work that are probably beneath your pay grade. They see you being treated as less than. The Judgment card says that they expect that you're going to make a change, that you're going to be able to leave this situation in the near future, and it will be because of good karma. What is it about the Judgment card? Yep, there you go. That you're very nurturing, you're very kind, you're very loving, that you're bringing that energy in, and that is going to give you another opportunity to leave the situation that you find exhausting. So why do we have the Tower card here? Now, this is just a fear. Your person fears getting in some sort of an argument with you. The Father of Wands is very feisty energy. That is Leo energy. Your person feels as though you do not like to get in in ego-driven battles. That if they were to challenge you, though, or really sort of argue with you over something that you didn't find reasonable, that you would really bring that lightning strike in. You're just not a person. You're very much a Virgo energy. You're very much about daily life, living it well. They feel as though you're just not a person who's going to be in any kind of a relationship where there's a temper, there's toxicity, that there isn't a strong foundation. Let's see why they fear this card. Why do they fear the energy of the Tower? What is the energy? Heart of the Fairy Oracle tells us sort of an integral inside look at their workings, a hope. Oh, that's beautiful. That is absolutely the best energy that you could pull, because your person is feeling very much the same way. Your person does not. They fear drama. And the hope is that you are sharing that value. And from what I can see, Aquarius, you certainly do share that value. So I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please leave a comment below. Tell me where you're viewing the video from. I'm broadcasting from Chicago. Give me any ideas for readings that you'd like to see. And in the meantime, we always appreciate support with a subscribe. Thanks so much, Aquarius. Take care. Bye-bye.